Welcome to Trans Theories, the show where we talk about everything Transformers. I'm Jason, and today we're going to be talking about how the Wreckers became weaponized. Now, if you do not know who the Wreckers are, the Wreckers were an Autobot trio of engineers who were pretty damn rude. But the thing that made this Autobot trio memorable was the fact that these Autobots could turn into race cars with guns. Now, I believe that the Wreckers were originally stock cars before they became weaponized. And also, to make this video easier to follow, I came up with a new term to classify the Wreckers as. And that term would be calling them a weaponizer. Now, I did not come up with the name myself. I actually borrowed it from a term from a Transformers Prime toy line that was called Weaponizers. And the whole gimmick of this toy line was that a figure in its toy line could deploy a hidden machine gun in vehicle mode and in robot mode, which definitely resembles a lot of Stealth Force. And also on the topic of Stealth Force, I did a video on how Stealth Force was created and why it was discontinued, so don't forget to check it out. But now back on the topic of the Wreckers, we gotta ask ourselves,
what would Jesus do?
How the Wreckers got these weapons built into them in the first place. Now, a reasonable fan theory that I came up with a few months ago that could work for answering this question is, quote, because the Wreckers are engineers and they designed a Xantium, then they must have made themselves weaponized, end quote. Well, this old fan theory of mine does have a good point, and even in a TF Wiki it does state that the Wreckers did make their own weapons, but the main flaw in this is, how did the Wreckers modify their overall armored up look? And with this question, it completely shuts down this theory. But taking information from previous videos, TF Wiki content, and of course my own touch, I came up with the most logical answer to this question. And if you've seen my How Stealth Force Was Created and Why It Was Discontinued video, you already know the answer. But to explain it to new viewers, the answer is this. During the events between Revenge of the Fallen and Dark of the Moon, one character came down to Earth in the second wave of Autobots. And that certain character would be the one and only Q, also known as Wheeljack. And once Q came down with the Wreckers and Dino, they scanned their vehicle modes, and they made their way to the newly upgraded Nest. And once they all started to adapt better to Earth, this was the time Q wanted to work on some of his experiments, like he did on the Days of Cybertron. So he came up with a project that was codenamed Stealth Force. And what Stealth Force would do is, let a Transformer have the speed of their vehicle mode, while having the firepower, if not more, of their robot form. But the main thing was, that the Stealth Force weapons could retract back inside the Transformer. So Q wanted the three most fastest Autobots at the time, so we asked the Wreckers, but the Wreckers were a bit disappointed that the weapons would have to retract, and they wanted to have something even more powerful than Stealth Force. So Q put each of them in a sleep stasis, and once they were in this stasis, Q started to add, remove, and upgrade parts that were on the Wreckers, and Q also made some of his finest weapons to add to the Wreckers, and before Q knew it, he created living weapons, with the power of speed, resistance, intelligence, and most of all, strength. The Wreckers are truly unstoppable.
Until we get the Age of Extinction!